basketball fans, and welcome back to the Red Zone. I say welcome back. It's the second game that we have been here, maybe the first that you are joining us for. But we are at the Red Zone for boys basketball action here on a Thursday night. It is game two of a triple header here at the Red Zone with the Antwerp Archers in town. The freshman game was played first. That went the way of the Aces, 36-10. And now junior varsity basketball as we are getting ready to get underway. And we've got Hunter Evans getting ready to jump center with number 40 for Antwerp, who's not on the junior varsity roster, which I believe, well, let's see if we can figure out who that is. Shot is up and good, and the Archers will take a quick 2-0 lead. Hunter Evans, bounce pass over to Dylan Evans. Dylan getting the start tonight, shot is no good. Rebound comes down to Hunter Knoll, who tosses it over to Cole Sessler. And to Sessler, down into the corner, shot is up. And that one's good, number 32, Altimus. On the other end, shot put up by Gage Yoder. And that's no good, but Gage will go to the line. It's Hunter Evans, Dylan Evans, Gage Yoder. Also on the floor, Quentin Peffley. And number 23, Lucas Yoder. Gage Yoder's first shot is good. Makes it 5-1. That one's no good, but the putback is Lucas Yoder with his first bucket of the night to make it 5-3. Come back the other way with the Archers. Pass in, up and no good. Rebound comes down to the Aces. Lucas Yoder tries to get it to Peffley. Stolen away by Altimus. Altimus going to go the distance. He'll stop and travel. Dooley, Knoll, Sessler, Altimus, and the mysterious number 40 on the floor. Long shot, no good. Rebound grabbed by Sessler. As Antwerp goes back on offense, again leading by two, 5-3. Knoll puts the shot up, no good. Peffley grabs the board for the Aces. He'll come back the other way. Peffley tosses it over to Luke Yoder. Yoder doing traffic directing. Bounce pass inside, and the ball's kicked. Should stay with the Aces. Quick substitution into the game. Wearing number 5, Michael Myers. Did very well in the freshman game earlier. Peffley inbounds to Myers. Myers to Luke Yoder. Yoder back to Myers. Down in the corner, Hunter Evans feeds it into Peffley. Back out to Hunter. Hunter puts it up. No good. Rebound knocked out of bounds. Should stay with the Aces. Hunter Evans with the ball for the Aces. Over to Myers. Back to Evans. Move it around the perimeter. Lucas Yoder, bounce pass to Myers. Myers from three-point land is good. Myers gives the Aces their first lead of the night, 6-5. Back the other way with the Archers. Shot up and no good from Sessler. Put back, and that's no good. We're going to have a whistle, and I believe that that's going to send Dooley to the line to shoot two. Dooley's first shot, no good. Second one is good for Dooley. And the Aces are going to have the ball at midcourt on the far side. Beffley inbounds to Myers, down to Hunter Evans. Evans kicks it back to Lucas Yoder. Yoder to Peffley. Quickly back to Myers. Down to Dylan Evans. Knocked out. Pass almost stolen away. Now we're going to have a jump ball. Quick hands by Altimus. Knocked the pass. Loose. And in the end, jump ball. And that goes the way of the Aces. Brayton Stuckey, number 24, checking in for Antwerp. Peffley gets the ball inbounds to Myers. They'll work it down to Hunter Evans. Evans put it up, no good, but he's going to draw the foul. Hunter's going to go to the line to shoot two. That'll be team foul number three on Antwerp and the first personal on Stuckey. First one for Evans is good. Hunter has one more. Gets that one too. Hunter Evans makes it 8-6. Coming back the other way, Sessler. To Stuckey. Stuckey. Guarded by Dylan Evans, having some trouble. Gets it over to Noel, who tosses it back to Sasslar. To number 40. Shot is up, and that one's good for Hunter Noel. Noel makes it an 8 all game. Myers down to the corner, Dylan Evans. Evans will kick it back out to Myers. Alley-oop pass over to Hunter Evans, and he'll toss it back out to Myers, top of the key. Myers kicks it out to Lucas Yoder. Yoder goes up to the free throw line, puts it up, no good. Rebound grabbed out of there by Noel. He'll go over to Sasslar, and he'll toss it over to Altimus. Altimus back out to Sasslar, over to Noel, to Altimus. Deflected. Ball's loose. Sessler gets it back on the sideline. Kicks it back out to Altimus, who puts it up from three-point land. Good. Altimus. And a foul. Or a turnover, I should say. Archer's up now 11-8. Noel looking to get the ball inbounds. Does. Stuckey over to Sessler. Sessler tosses it to Altimus. Altimus travels. Now turn it back over to the Aces with 33.4 seconds left in this fast-moving first quarter. Peffley inbounds to Myers. Myers back to Peffley, quickly to Hunter Evans. Evans hangs on to it, gets it back to Peffley, and Peffley travels. 25 seconds. It'll be Antwerp's ball on the inbounds. They'll get the ball in to Sessler. Sessler to Stuckey. Back to Sessler. With 13 seconds. Sessler to Altimus. Altimus back to Sessler. Sessler drives into the paint with five, puts it up off glass, and good. First points of the night for Cole Sessler, and that's the end of the first quarter. A rock'em sock'em, fast-moving first quarter which sees the Archers on top by five, 13-8. And as we get ready for second quarter action in this junior varsity game, we'll say a big thank you here to our basketball broadcast underwriters on Hicksville Community Television, the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships in Hicksville, Ohio. If you're in the market for a vehicle, car, truck, van, SUV, stop by, check out the great selection that they have at the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships, both at Jim Schmidt Chevrolet Buick and at Jim Schmidt Ford. Don't forget to the Jim Schmidt truck lot. If you don't see what you want on the lot, make sure you let the fine folks at Jim Schmidt know what it is you're looking for, because they always do their very best to see to it that you get exactly the vehicle that you want. They've got terrific service before, during, and after the sale. You couldn't ask for a better group of people to work with for your transportation needs. So again, you owe it to yourself to stop by and see what's happening at the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships in Hicksville, Ohio, and online at jimschmidtauto.com. Back into action here in this junior varsity game. The Archers leading by five, and with the ball, Cole Sessler pitches the ball over to Hunter Knoll. Knoll drives down, has to back it back out, gets it to Altimus. Altimus will kick it back. Shot is up and no good from Knoll, but the Archers grab the board. That one's put up by Sessler. No good. Pefley grabs the rebound for the Aces. Tosses it over to Myers. Myers feeds off to Hunter Evans, who gets it into Dillon. Tries to get it back to Hunter, knocked out of bounds by the Archers. Ball will stay with the Aces. Pefley. Bounce pass into Dillon Evans. His turnaround jumper, no good. Rebound grabbed by Altimus. He'll go over to Sessler. Sessler tossing it to Stuckey. He'll work it around the perimeter. Back to Sessler at the top of the key. Sessler. Ball on the inside, knocked loose, rolling around on the floor. Hunter Evans comes up with it for the Aces. Still down by five. Pefley deflected, but Evans picks it up to Myers. Back to Pefley. Pefley drives baseline, puts it up. No good. Ball grabbed by Knoll. He'll toss it back to Sessler, and we'll come the other way with the Archers. Antwerp with the ball and the lead as we are about 4 minutes away from halftime in this junior varsity game. Partially blocked, saved on the baseline, but inbounds to an Ace player. Hunter Evans grabs it to Dillon Evans. Dillon controls the pass, gets tied up a little bit. His turnaround jumper, good. Evans gets his first bucket of the night. They close the gap a little bit. 13-10 now, Aces down by three. Toss over to Hunter Knoll. Knoll working around the perimeter. Back over to Sessler. Sessler puts it up. No good. But he's going to be fouled. And that's going to be Dillon Evans picking up his first personal foul. That'll be team foul number three. Excuse me, team foul number two on the Aces. And Sessler goes to the line. Gets the first one. Makes it 14-10. Quick substitution, number 40 coming back into the game. I think that's either Dillon Peters or Matt Jones. We're going to see if we can figure that out for you. Sessler's second shot is also good. Here come the Aces. Myers over to Yoder. Lucas bounce pass to Hunter Evans. Evans back to Yoder. Yoder to Myers. Myers from three-point land. Good. Myers' second tray of the night makes it 15-13 as the Aces close to within a bucket. Sussler guarded by Hunter Evans. Tosses it over to Altimus. Altimus back to Sussler. Down low to Stuckey. Back out to Sussler. Sussler drives into the paint, kicks it back out to Altimus. His long three, no good. Rebound. Stuckey bouncing around with it. You're going to have a whistle. And we're going to have a foul called. Lucas Yoder, his first. Team foul number three. So the Antwerp's ball out of bounds. Sussler with it at the top of the key as we are under 3 minutes to go past the halfway point of this second quarter. Sussler is again the archers moving it around the perimeter. Altimus drives in. He puts it up off glass and good. Keaton Altimus. 7 points on the night now. Myers tries to run it down before it goes out of bounds and is unsuccessful, so it'll be Archer's ball on the sideline. 2:29 to go in the game. Kick it back in. Hunter Knoll puts it over to Sussler, who tried to feed it back to Knoll and goes out of bounds. Deflected by one of the Hicksville players. So possession stays with Antwerp. Ball inbounds, quickly put up, no good. And grabbed on the baseline by the Aces. Here comes Michael Myers. Myers over to Hunter Evans down in the corner. Evans feeds it inside to Yoder. Kicks it back out to Dylan Evans, who puts it up. Off the iron, no good. Gets his own rebound. Up, count it, and he's going to the line. Dylan Evans gets his own rebound, puts up a strong shot, draws the foul. That'll be number two, second personal on number 40. Will come out of the game. He'll be replaced by Dooley, number 21. I believe that's sophomore Dylan Peters. Shot is good from Evans. That makes it 16-17. Antwerp leading now by a point. .140. Altimus with the ball. Over to Dooley. To Sesslar. Back to Altimus. 90 seconds left before halftime in this junior varsity game. Sussler kicks it back out to Altimus, who will take a three-point shot, and it's good. Altimus, 10 points now for the young man in this JV game, makes it 20-16. Aces down by four. Lucas Yoder gets it to Hunter Evans. Lucas Yoder, Gage Yoder back in the game too. Tried to feed it into him and kind of bounces it. Bounce pass off of Sessler's face. Rubbing his nose a little bit. Lucas Yoder getting ready to handle the inbounds chores. Gets it into Myers. Over to Hunter Evans. Back to Lucas. Yoder drives in. Kicks it back out to Myers. Myers over to Hunter Evans. Evans will drive in. Feed it over to Yoder. Lucas will put it up. No good. Rebound. Grabbed by Altimus, quickly the other way. Altimus kicks it back out to Sesslar with 40 seconds before halftime. Sessler tosses it over to Stuckey. I'll work it around the perimeter. Altimus with it now. He drives to the hoop, up, no good. Rebound, grabbed by Antwerp. Dooley with it now with 26 seconds. Back to Sesslar, out on top. Sesslar to Altimus on the wing. They put it inside. Knocked out of there by Hunter Evans. Knoll had the ball. Hunter slaps it out. It'll stay with Antwerp. 17.5 seconds before halftime. Knoll, long inbounds, gets it in to Altimus, or excuse me, to Sessler. Sessler feeds it over to Altimus, and we're going to whistle as Gage Yoder hits the deck. That's going to be a foul on Cesslar, his second personal. As Caleb Klein will check in for Cesslar here late in the second quarter. Hunter Evans, 13 seconds. Gets it into Lucas Yoder. Yoder quickly down the floor. Aces down by four with 7 seconds. Bounce pass to Myers, down to Hunter Evans. Evans for three off the side of the backboard, no good, and that'll be the end of the first half. So we've reached halftime of this junior varsity game, and at the half, it's the Antwerp Archers on top of the Aces by four, 20-16, your halftime score. We'll take a break, but we invite you to stay with us. We'll be back shortly, and we'll have all the exciting second half play-by-play coming your way right here on Hicks TV. As we're about a minute away from getting the second half underway in this junior varsity game. And again, if you're just joining us, JV score at halftime, Archers leading the Aces 20-16. Boys junior varsity basketball action. Unofficial scoring in the first half for the Aces. In half number one, their leading scorer, Michael Myers, the freshman, bucketed a couple of three-pointers for six. It was Dylan Evans with a couple of field goals and a free throw for five. 2 points each in the first half for Lucas Yoder and for Hunter Evans, and a point from the free throw line for Gage Yoder as well. On the Antwerp Archers side, leading scorer in double figures in the first half, Keaton Altimus with a couple of three-pointers and a couple of two-pointers for 10. 4 points in the first half from Cole Cesslar. Peters with a three-point shot for three. 2 points for Hunter Knoll and a free throw, and 1 point for Matt Dooley. So here we go. Aces with the ball to get things started in the second half. Peffley inbounds it to Lucas Yoder. Yoder to Hunter Evans. Evans, pull-up jumper, off the iron, no good. Rebound grabbed by Peters. He tosses it over to Cesslar, rather. Cesslar to Knoll. Down to Peters, who's tied up with Hunter Evans. Jump ball. Possession arrow gives the ball to Antwerp. Bounce pass in to Peter. Puts up, no good. Slapped out of bounds, and that'll be Aces ball. Peffley, long inbounds, knocked loose, picked up by the Antwerp Archers. Stuckey with the ball. Excuse me, that was Dooley. Shots no good. Dylan Evans grabs the rebound, tosses it over to Lucas Yoder, and come back the other way with the Aces, down by four. Peffley. Over to Lucas Yoder, bounce pass inside to Dylan Evans, kicks it out to Hunter Evans. Bounce pass back to Dylan, back to Hunter. Hunter drives baseline. He'll put up the hook shot, no good. Ball out of bounds. The rebound grabbed by Antwerp. Noel had it, but he stepped on the baseline. So out of bounds to the Aces. Definitely will see if he can get it inbounds for Hicksville. Bounce pass into Dylan Evans to Hunter Evans on the wing. Down to Peffley in the corner. Peffley rockets it across court to Lucas Yoder. Bounce pass into Gage Yoder is deflected, loose on the floor. Peters grabs it for the Archers. Over to Altimus, who tosses it over to Knoll. Knoll guarded by Lucas Yoder. Passes off to Cesslar. Cesslar guarded by Hunter Evans. To Altimus, back to Cesslar, back to Knoll. Knoll to Dooley, down to Altimus, back to Knoll. We'll work around the perimeter. Driving in, kicking back out. Knoll guarded by Lucas Yoder. He'll try to take it in. He'll have to back it back out. Inside to Peters. Peters, nothing there. He kicks it back out to Sessler. Sessler puts up the jump shot. No good. Rebound knocked out of bounds off the hands of Sessler. It'll be Ace's ball. Myers will come back in for Gage Yoder on the Hicksville side of things. Pefley, long inbounds to Dylan Evans. Back to Pefley as they're getting some pressure now on Antwerp. Evans works his way through traffic, lays it up off glass and good. Hunter Evans breaks the scoring ice in the second half, and Aces draw within 2, 20-18. Knoll with the ball for Antwerp. Tries to feed it inside to Dooley. Dooley's turnaround, no good. He's fouled, and he'll go to the line to shoot two. So Matt Dooley fouled by Dylan Evans. That's Dylan's second personal foul. Aces' first team foul of the half. And that will put Matt Dooley at the line to shoot two. Misses the first one. Also coming in, Brayton Stuckey, number 24 for the Archers. Dooley's second shot, no good. Hunter Evans grabs the rebound over to Lucas Yoder. Yoder goes into the crowd and gets fouled. And one of the Archers, I think it was Dooley, got popped in the mouth. And they're going to call the foul on Stuckey. That'll be his second personal. Common foul, so Aces will have the ball out of bounds. On the baseline, down by two. As we're just about halfway through this third quarter. Pefley rockets it into Myers. Myers over to Lucas Yoder. Quickly to Hunter Evans in the corner. Evans shot up, no good. Pefley with the board, tries to put it back up, and he's fouled. That'll send Pefley to the line to shoot a couple. And I think that's going to be Peter picking up his third personal foul. So Peters, three fouls hanging around his neck. Pefley gets it. Pefley's first point of the night comes from the free throw line to make it 20-19. And Brett Falk off of the freshman squad, number 15 coming in for Antwerp. Pefley hits them both. And we'll come back the other way with the Antwerp Archers tied at 20. Altimus goes in baseline. He pulls up. Shot no good, but Altimus will go to the line. He'll draw the foul. And that'll be the third personal on Dylan Evans. That's team foul number two now on the Aces. Antwerp also with two team fouls. Altimus gets the first one. This is his first free throw of the night that he's made. Salvador Ovalos into the game now for Dylan Evans. Altimus' second shot, good. 12 points now for Keaton. And we'll come back the other way. Myers with the ball for the Aces over to Lucas Yoder. Feeds it inside to Ovalos. Ovalos gets it out of there to Pefley, who puts it up and in. Pefley with the bucket, and we're tied at 22. Altimus driving in, puts the ball up, and good. And we come back the other way with the Aces, now down by two. Lucas Yoder to Myers hits the three. And the Aces now up by one. Sessler driving down for the Archers. Sessler from the free throw line, no good. Rebound. And we're going to have a tie up and a jump ball between Hunter Evans and Sessler, and that should go to the Aces. It does. Heffley inbounds to Myers. Myers to Heffley. To Hunter Evans. Pass stolen by Sessler. Gets it to Altimus, who puts it up. No good. He's going to be fouled. They'll whistle Lucas Yoder for his second personal foul. And again, Keaton Altimus at the line to shoot two. Down by one. First shot, good. We're tied at 25. Altimus will have one more. Gage Yoder into the game now as Hunter Evans will have a seat. Altimus second shot, no good. We remain tied at 25. Sessler dives in there and gets tied up with Gage Yoder, and it's a jump ball, and that one should go to the Archers. And we're going to have a timeout called. 1:50 to go here in quarter number three. The Aces have battled back from a four-point halftime deficit to tie the game, 25 apiece. As Hicksville will take their first timeout of this junior varsity game, they'll have four remaining. No timeouts taken so far by Antwerp, so they've got their full complement of five. Three team fouls committed so far by the Aces, two for the Archers. As we get ready to get back in action, it'll be the Antwerp Archers ball out of bounds on the baseline. As this has the makings, so it could be kind of a wild and woolly game here tonight. Ball inbounds off the hands, and Salvador Ovalles comes away with it for the Aces. He'll hold it up, get it to Myers. Myers down to Lucas Yoder, who travels down in the corner. Turns it back over to the Antwerp Archers. Inbounds to Sessler. It's Hunter Evans getting ready to check back in for the Aces. Sessler across the timeline. Down to Knoll. And Sessler gets it knocked out of bounds. Last touched by him. So Aces will get the turnover. Quick pause in the action. Player gets his shoe tied. And here we go. Heffley inbounds to Myers with a minute 30 to go in the third quarter. Tied at 25. Myers to Heffley to Hunter Evans. Evans back to Heffley. Bounce pass inside to Ovalles to Hunter, who puts it up underneath the hoop, and he's fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot two. I believe that's going to be Hunter Knoll picking up his first personal foul, team foul number three for the Archers. Hunter Evans at the line, shooting two. Bingo gets the first one. Ace is up by a point now. Hunter has one more. In and out, no good. Rebound comes down to Altimus. Altimus gets it over to Sessler. He'll come back the other way with the Archers. The minute 10 to go in quarter number three. Sessler being guarded by Hunter Evans. Working around. Ball down low and stolen away by Gage Yoder. Gets it over to Myers. Myers going to pick up a foul courtesy of Hunter Knoll. That'll be Knoll's second personal and the Archers' fourth team foul. Heffley inbounds to Myers. Under a minute to go here in quarter number three. Aces up by one. Heffley back to Myers. Myers feeds it down to Gage Yoder inside to Ovalles. Ovalles works his way up to the hoop. Up and good. Salvador Ovalles gets a big bucket here late in the third quarter to put the Aces up by three, 28-25. 30 seconds, and Altimus back to, well, now over to Knoll, now back to Sessler, and back to Knoll with 22. Knoll looking for some help, kicks it out to Sessler. Sessler with 15 seconds, drives into the paint, kicks it back out to Knoll, guarded by Ovalles. Down low, off a bunch of aces and out of bounds. That should stay with the Antwerp Archers with 6.5 seconds left in quarter number three. Stuckey looking to get the ball inbounds. Lobs it in to Sessler with 5 seconds. Sessler doesn't have a lot of time. Puts it up, no good. Put back up, no good. And that's the end of the third quarter. And the Archers aren't able to get a shot off. Well, they get a shot off. They're not able to get it to drop. So they're shut out there in that last stanza. And after three, the Aces are in the lead now by 3, 28-25. We'll get ready for the fourth quarter. And as we do, we'll say another big thank you to the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealership, our basketball broadcast underwriters here on Hicksville Community Television for the 2015 and 16 school year. We have a lot of basketball coming your way. We've already covered a great deal. We've got a lot more coming, and it's all made possible thanks to the generous underwriting support of the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships. Thanks to them, we're able to bring you both boys and girls basketball action from the junior high level all the way up through the varsity, including the big triple-header nights like tonight, where we've got the freshman, junior varsity, and varsity games still to come. And, of course, when tournament time rolls around, we'll be on the road following both the Aces boys and girls down the tournament trail, and all of that made possible because of the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships in Hicksville, Ohio, and online at jimschmidtauto.com. We cannot thank them enough for their continued support. Final 6 minutes of the night. Aces up by three. Sessler with the ball for the Antwerp Archers. Nearly throws it away. Noel grabs it for Antwerp. Guarded by Avios, and we're going to have a whistle. And Avios is going to get hit with a reach-in. That'll be his first personal. And team foul number four on the Aces. Noel looking to get the ball inbounds. He'll toss it in to Sessler. Guarded by Hunter Evans. Sessler to Noel. Noel driving in, puts it up off glass, no good. Myers grabs the board for the Aces. Way downfield and overshoots everybody, throws it out of bounds, and turns it over to the Antwerp Archers. Coach Dave Blue coming out saying, not quite so much mustard on the next pass down the court like that. Sessler across the timeline for the Antwerp Archers, down by three in this junior varsity game. Over to Altimus. Altimus loses the dribble and goes out of bounds. It'll be Aces ball. 5:13 to go in the game. Pefley will get ready to inbounds it for the Aces. A break, and he gets it into Myers. Myers, some full court pressure being shown by the Archers now. Myers, cross half court. Bounce pass to Pefley. Back to Myers. Down to Hunter Evans. Evans down in the corner. He'll feed it in to Gage Yoder. He'll put it up. No good. Saved but grabbed by Noel for Antwerp. Gets it over to Sessler. Sessler down to Dooley. Back to Sessler, who puts it up. And that's good. 4-3. Sessler hits the tray, ties it up at 28, and quickly timeout called by the Antwerp Archers. 4:41 left to go in the game, as this one I think is going to go down to the wire. We'll make sure got enough tape in the camera. Well, it looks like we're in good shape here. It's been a fast-moving junior varsity game. 4:41 again to go in the contest, as the Antwerp Archers hit the three and immediately call their first time out of the game. So we'll get back into action. It'll be the Aces ball after the successful three-point shot from Cole Sessler. Heffley, full court pressure from the Archers once again, gets it into Hunter Evans, who quickly barrels down towards the backboard, puts it up, no good. Sessler grabs the board for Antwerp, tosses it over to Altimus. Altimus back to Sessler, to Dooley. Dooley to Noel. So see if they can get something to open up. Knocked away. and out of bounds. Should stay with the Archers. And it does. So Noel will get ready to try to get the ball in bounds. Noel tosses it in. It's a long inbounds to Sessler. Guarded by Myers. Sessler across half court. He'll stop right there at the arc. Back it up. Myers come out after him. Over to Altimus. Altimus will flick him a quick signal. Back to Sessler, who puts it up. No good. Ball grabbed by Hunter Evans. Evans quickly the other way. Hunter going to drive to the hoop. Up off glass and good. Evans gets the bucket, and the Aces back up by a deuce. 30-28. Sessler backing it off. Over to Noel. Noel to Dooley. Dooley going to drive baseline. He'll put it up. No good. Pefley grabs the rebound. Clinton take it up court. Bounce pass over to Myers. Myers down to Hunter Evans, to Dylan Evans, back in the game. His shot is rejected by Peters. And the Archers come the other way with the ball. Dooley over to Noel. Noel gets it back to Sessler. Sessler almost the over and back, but he didn't go over the half line, so able to control the ball without taking that step. So not an over and back call. Sessler looking things over as we're past the halfway point of the fourth quarter. Peters back to Sessler. Sessler, spin move as he goes to the hoop, and he's going to draw the foul. That'll be Myers, who will pick it up. That's his first personal and team foul number 5 on the Aces, but it will send Sessler to the line to shoot 2 and possibly tie the game up if he hits them both. Sessler gets the first one. He's done pretty well at the free throw line so far this evening. He'll have one more. Sessler misses the second one, and we're going to have another whistle. And I think that's going to be number 4 on Mr. Peters. It is. Team foul number 5 on the Archers. Aces will get the ball out of bounds. Pefley inbounds it to Myers. Again, full court pressure from the Archers. Pass to Pefley. Quickly down to Hunter Evans. Evans to Myers. Myers pull the trigger from 3-point land. No good. Rebound loose on the floor. Bouncing around. And jump ball called. Some fans calling for the travel call because he rolled over holding the ball. But either way, it's going to be the Aces ball on the baseline. With a 1-point lead, 30-29. Pefley, bounce pass into Dylan Evans to Hunter Evans. Evans will drive in towards the hoop, put it up off glass, no good. And we're going to have a whistle. And another foul. And that's going to be on the Archers again. That'll be number 3 on Noel. Team foul number 6 on Antwerp. Aces get the ball inbounds quickly around the perimeter. Pefley in the corner. He'll drive into the paint, put it up. No good. Last touch by White, out of bounds. It'll be Antwerp's ball. 2:11 to go in the game. In this junior varsity contest, Aces up by 1. Here we go. Sessler guarded by Myers. Myers gets the ball loose. Myers quickly the other way, goes to the hoop, puts it up, no good. I'm going to wave it off. And they're going to say he wasn't fouled, but ball knocked out of bounds, so to stay with the Aces. Myers was hoping to be able to go to the, and now we're going to have an inbounds, and they're going to wave that one off. And that's going to be on blue number 24, Brayton Stuckey. And that will put the Aces in the bonus, team foul number 7. So Gage Yoder at the line to shoot 1-1. Yoder gets the first one. Makes it 31-29. Yoder, they're going to wave that one off. Lane violation. So it'll be Antwerp's ball with 1:56 to go. Aces up by 2 now, 31-29. Sessler, bounce pass to Peters. Peters to Altimus, puts it up and in. Altimus with the hoop to tie it up at 31. Hunter Evans gets the inbound into a double team, feeds it down to Gage Yoder, gets it back to Hunter Evans. Evans partially deflected, but Myers grabs it at the top of the key to Pefley. Down to Evans in the corner. Evans, long cross court to Myers, down to Gage Yoder. Yoder looking for some help, gets it back to Myers with 1:16. Hunter Evans drives it into the paint. Evans puts it up, no good. Rebound grabbed by Altimus. Gets it over to Sessler, and we come back the other way with the Antwerp Archers. Sessler working his way through, and a timeout from the Antwerp Archers bench. With 1:01 left to go in this junior varsity game, we're tied at 31. Full 1 minute timeout taken by the Antwerp Archers. And of course, this is the second game that is being played here tonight at the Red Zone. Again, the freshman game went to the Aces. They overpowered the freshman squad from Antwerp, 36-10. The final score hasn't been quite as lopsided an affair in this junior varsity game, a very entertaining game to watch. We're tied at 31 with a minute to go in the contest. And of course, stick around on Hicks TV, check the program guide. John Piasecki running the camera for us tonight is going to be staying with me. John and I are going to be hanging out, and we'll be bringing you coverage of the varsity matchup between Antwerp and the Hicksville Aces as well here on Hicksville Community Television. Big night of basketball on this Thursday, January 7th. Triple header for you. And we're glad to be here in case you aren't able to be. And even if you are, first off, you might have the fun of seeing yourself on TV out there in the crowd. Then you can watch it again. See if they got all those calls right and everything. Noel gets it in to Sessler, feeds it in to Peters. His turnaround, no good, but he's fouled. And Dylan Peters going to go to the line. And that'll be Hunter Evans' second foul. So Peters misses the first one. That's team foul number 6, too, so afterwards, after this foul, they'll be shooting the 1-1 as well for Antwerp. Peter's second one, and he gets that one to drop. So we'll go down the other end. Myers with the ball to Hunter Evans, back to Myers. He'll put it up for 3. No good. Long rebound grabbed by Sessler. And here come the Archers up by 1, 32-31. Sessler puts it up. No good. Rebound grabbed by Pefley with 33 seconds. Myers comes the other way with 30 seconds. Over to Pefley with 27. Kicks it over to Gage Yoder, to Myers with 23. Inside to Hunter Evans. Puts it up. No good. Rebound. And we got a whistle, and we got a Antwerp Archer hitting the deck. That's going to be a foul on Gage Yoder. That'll be a technical foul on Gage Yoder. That's his first. And that's going to send Stuckey to the line to shoot the 2 technical throws. He misses the first one. So it stays a 1-point game. 18.5 seconds left in the contest. Archers leading 32-31. Stuckey his second. And he misses that one too. So it'll be Antwerp's ball out of bounds on the baseline, 18.5 seconds. Getting things squared away. Knoll inbounds to Sessler. Sessler's going to get fouled. See whether they give it to Yoder or to Myers. It's going to be Myers. Pushing off. That'll be his second personal. So with 16.5 seconds, we'll go down to the other end. And that's going to put Cole Sessler at the line, shooting 1-1. Sessler misses the front end, grabs his own rebound, and he's going to get fouled again. This time he's going to shoot two regardless. That's going to be Dylan Evans picking up his fourth personal foul. Still a one-point game, and now first shot is good. So Sessler makes this one count and puts them up by two, 33-31, and he'll have one more. Sessler's second shot, also good. And now it's a three-point game and timeout on the floor. 13.8 seconds and a full one-minute timeout called by the Archers, wanting to hold on to this lead, and it's going to be all about trying to prevent the Aces from being able to get a good look at the basket from three-point land. Three-point shot will send the game into overtime in all likelihood. And it looks like Lucas Yoder getting ready to check back in for the Aces junior varsity squad. Aces have committed 9 team fouls, so if they do commit any more fouls in those last few seconds, the Antwerp Archers will shoot 2 shots regardless. It'll be the double bonus for them. Archers have 7 team fouls to their credit, so the Aces are in the bonus, shooting 1-1. And we'll break huddle and get ready to head into the last 14 seconds of this junior varsity game. And before anything happens, the Aces will call a timeout. So, a 1 minute timeout by the Archers, followed immediately by a 1 minute timeout by the Aces. So we'll build some more time here. Coach Dave Blue talks over with his squad. Looks like it's going to be Hunter Evans, Dylan Evans, Heffley Myers, and Lucas Yoder taking the floor for the Aces for this last few seconds. And it looks like Peters, Sessler, Altimus, Knoll, and Stuckey for the Archers. Hoping to hang on here and come away with a junior varsity victory here in the Green Meadows Conference. Aces break huddle, and here we go. 13.8 seconds. That can take us a while to play. Again, both teams with 3 timeouts. Both teams in the bonus. So here we go. Heffley inbounds to Myers. 12 seconds. Myers across the timeline with 8. Myers down to Hunter Evans. Evans, Myers pulls the trigger from way outside, and that's going to be the game. Shot is no good from Michael Myers. And your JV final score. Wow, they took that down off the scoreboard really fast. And it was 31-34. So the scoreboard not wasting any time tonight, putting that 20 seconds up to get ready for the varsity game. So your final score, 34-31. And I'm going to fill in some of the scoring here so we can get you some unofficial scores for the game tonight. Okay, so let's run down the unofficial scoring. Again, for the Aces on the short end of the 34-31 score. Hicksville led tonight by Michael Myers, the freshman. Three three-pointers for 9 points when all is said and done. 7 points tonight from Hunter Evans on a couple of field goals and three free throws. 5 points for Dylan Evans, a couple of field goals and a free throw. And then 4 points from Quentin Pepley, all in the second half. 2 points each tonight from Sal Alvios, from Gage Yoder, and from Lucas Yoder. And for the Antwerp Archers, a couple of archers in double figures tonight. Leading all scorers was Keaton Altimus, who finished up tonight with 17 big points for the Antwerp Archers and 10 points for Cole Seslar this evening as well. 4 points from Peters, 2 points from Hunter Knoll, and a point off of the free throw line from Nath Dooley. There you have it, 34-31. The Aces missing that three-pointer just before the buzzer to give the win to the JV squad from Antwerp. So that's going to wrap up our junior varsity basketball coverage. Hope you enjoyed it, an exciting and fun game. And as we wrap up, again, we'll say a big thank you to the Hicksville Athletic Department and, of course, to our basketball broadcast underwriters, the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships in Hicksville, Ohio. And with that, well, we'll wrap it up. We'll invite you, though, to stay tuned to HIX-TV and keep your eye on the program guide. John Piasecki and I will be sticking around for the varsity basketball game, covering that for you on HIX-TV as well. So with that, we'll say one more time, final score tonight, boys junior varsity basketball action. It was the Antwerp Archers defeating the Hicksville Aces 34-31. For John Piasecki on the camera, I'm Bill Murphy with Hicksville Community Television, wishing you good night and good sports.